Good afternoon and welcome to the CostETN Data Management Workshop. And we will start this workshop with a question, and that is, why is data management important? Well, if you look to this picture, you will see a very messy office. And so the person itself is messy organized, and it will be hard to find any data, or at least for others to find what you need in this office. Most probably there will be data missing or some metadata. The things won't be well described, and it will be very hard to reconstruct what you need. And everybody organizes him or herself in a different way. And this makes it difficult for others to get insight in your way of working, or to get insight in how to get to the data or the metadata you need. So this is why we need to formalize ourselves when it comes to data. And that's why we need data management. But we don't only need data management. The data management also needs to be fair. And fair is being findable, accessible, interoperable, and reusable. Findable means that your data needs to be easy to find and needs to have sufficient rich metadata. And you should have unique and persistent identifiers. They are the DOIs as we know them. Of course, your data also needs to be accessible, and it should be accessible both for machines and for humans to understand it. And the data should be deposited in trusted repositories, as for instance, the one of the European Tracking Network. Further, interoperable means that your data should use formal and accessible language that has a broad use. And of course, last but not least, the data should be reusable. That means if you find the data, you should also be able to use it, and therefore the data should have a clear usage license. But why is this fair data so important? Well, first of all, it is, or it will become required from our funding. In Horizon 2020 projects, or in the upcoming Horizon Europe projects, all projects need to have a data management plan. So this is something very important in each of the projects. Further, it does aid in repeatability and validation of your work. It gives greater trust of the scientific results you have. And based on that, your data will be widely used, which leads to greater visibility and, in the end, in more citations. So you will become more famous with the work you've done, which doesn't mean that you will get more fortune, of course. Further, you will also have more complete data sets with information outside your own network. If your data is open to others, your metadata, it will be much more easy to know whose fish, for instance, was detected on one of your receivers. And if you share, others will share too, and we all gain by having access to more data. And as Nguyen et al. Mentioned, it is collaboration and engagement together will make sure your science becomes more actionable. You will be more cited and you will have more collaborations. And I will give an example of myself. When we started a couple of years with our network in the Belgian part of the North Sea, as you can see here, we had detections of unknown fish on our receivers. So each of these red triangles were locations where we had detections of fish we didn't know, we didn't tag ourselves. And after a couple of phone calls and emails, we found out that these were eels that had been tagged in the Netherlands, but also in Germany. And this led to a publication with co-authors from both Belgium and the Netherlands. But it didn't only lead to this one publication, it also led to joint projects and joint corporations. We have several projects running together now. We even have a joint PhD student, and it resulted in some additional tagging of some individuals of different species. So by sharing our data, by being open, this led to extra publications and other funding opportunities. Another example of the advantage of data sharing is that your data will be used in a wider context. Here I give the example on eel again, in which Pieter Jan Verhaalst, who is also part of the European Tracking Network, will do a meta-analysis on silver eel in European waters. And instead of only looking to the data of your own eels and unraveling just a small part of what the eels are doing in your study basin, Pieter Jan will look in a much broader context, which makes that your data becomes very important in the bigger picture. And a similar example can be found for brown toad, where Kim Burney of Denmark is leading a similar initiative. So, okay, we now know why data management is important, why the data should be fair. So let's have a look now to the ETN system, and afterwards let's try to get some data into the system. First of all, let's have a look to the data flow. So of course we start with gathering the data. Here I show you an example of acoustic telemetry, but we're broader than only acoustics, in which you have your receiver in the field, the data is retrieved from your receiver, and then we upload it on our personal computer. From the computer, we put it in the ETN data system using an online data entry form. This is the web application we built around the database. And then when the data is in the database, it can be visualized using a GeoServer in an ArcShiny application, and you can also perform your analysis in R. So there is an ETN package which you can use to get your data out of the ETN database and then start doing your analysis. And all the scripts and the package is available on GitHub. But more information on this later on. And here it is where it all starts. So on this web application, this is the landing page, where you can see all the projects that are already in the system that are running in Europe. So each of these dots represents one project performed in Europe. The red dots mean projects that have ended, and the blue dots are ongoing projects. Of course, there's much more ongoing in Europe, and that's why we have this meeting today, this workshop, because we want to feed this database and we want to get much more dots on this map, because the more inclusive the system becomes, the more interesting it will become. Okay, but so how can you add your data to the system? Therefore, you need to follow several steps. There are four major steps to do. First of all, you need to register. The registration is done at the website shown here on the slide. And after you have registered, you have to create a project using the template. So on the home page, on the bottom, you can see ETN project template. If you click that button, you will get a template that you can fill to create your project. Then you send this project information to us and we create for you a project for you. Once you have your project, you can start uploading your metadata. Of course, before we can upload any information on the detections, we need to have some information on your receivers and your tags used, where you deployed your receivers, and where you tagged your animals. I'm still basing myself here on acoustic telemetry, but as I mentioned before, ETN is broader than only acoustics. Okay, so for this registration, as mentioned, you go to this web link and then you provide with an email address and then you click register. When you register, by signing up to ETN, you do agree with the ETN data policy. There is a link to the details of the policy when you sign up, so I recommend everybody to read this policy. And then for the rest, you provide some information, some personal information, and then you are registered. So as I mentioned, after you're registered, you can start creating a project. So on the bottom of the homepage, you click this ETN project template, you fill the template and you send this to us. Some information on this template. We make a distinction between tracking projects and umbrella projects. A tracking project, as the title itself mentioned, is related to the tracking. This is what we need for this ETN database. First of all, we want to know which type of tracking do you use. Is it acoustic telemetry, or are you using data storage tags or satellites of p-tagging, for instance? And then based on that, you need to add some additional data on whether you're only tracking animals in an already existing network, or whether your project is also only a network or a combination of both. Besides this tracking project, we also have umbrella projects in which you can provide some metadata. These umbrella projects are just are projects that are much broader than or broader than only the tracking part. So it might be that in a specific project, telemetry or tracking is one part, but that there's much more done in the project. If you want, you can also provide information on that project. It's not necessary for ETN, but it's an option for you to do so. After you completed the file, you send it to us. Currently, it's still sent to me, but in the future, we will work with regional representatives. And then we upload your data in the system, your project in the system, and you can start entering your metadata. What is important is that how we organize all these projects in ETN. So as a researcher, you get access to a group. So one of the things you have to fill in the template is what's your group name. Mainly this is linked to the institute where you are working. So as a researcher, you get access to a group, and then a group has several projects. And you can always check on the dashboard. So on the landing page, if you click dashboard, you can always see which are the groups you are a member to and which projects are in your groups. I mentioned already before, but I mentioned it one last time. There are, of course, different types of tracking. And ETN started as a database for acoustic telemetry, but we are now working to enlarge the scope and make sure we will include all other tracking technologies in the future as well. For the moment, you can upload your project information for each type of tracking, but for the actual metadata and the detection data, currently it's only acoustic telemetry, but we are currently integrating the possibility to integrate data storage data. And in the next step, we will work on bit telemetry and satellite telemetry as well. So in the very near future, data storage data, archival data will be available to upload. And then in a couple of months to years, you will be able to upload all the other data as well.